What's this, all this West German stuff? This?
35.
35 for that one, 40 for that one. Yes to that one. This one?
35.
Yep, we'll take both of those. This one?
40.
40, take that as well. 150 so far. Put a little collection together. Excellent, excellent. Okay, happy with that.
I'll do it here. Okay.
Some mixes.
Great pair of planters.
That's brilliant.
Imagine the swearing they've seen.
When he started out in the trade, Drew spent years working markets like this and still has a soft spot for them today.
There's nothing more fun than wandering around an antique fair. Bacon sarnie, have a coffee, do a good bit of buying. I love this stuff.
Before he leaves, there's one more item that's caught Drew's eye, and it'd be potty to miss it.
Transylvanian chamber pot. Yeah. Oh, the things that's seen.
Yeah.
Oh, I need to wash my hand now. Oh.
It's made of Vampyrex.
Oh. How much is that potty?
30 quid.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah.
Just to make tea hold it.
This East European glazed jug, or chamber pot, is thought to be from the early 19th century. The simple blue and white design has been hand-painted and is typical of country pieces, which are in high demand at the moment. It could be worth around £120.
The beauty of places like this is, again, they can still have the essence of a house clearance about the shop as well, which it does, you know, because it's a real random mix, isn't it? There's all sorts of stuff in here. Down on a low shelf, there's a blue and white pot, handled pot. Very attractive. Filthy, but very attractive. Any sort of blue and white ware I can generally sell, and the more country it looks, the better, the more naive, really. So the printing on it and the firing and everything, the glaze is very, very simple, very country. And there's a fabulous and unique charm to this stuff.
This is a pretty thing. I've got the bowl to go on this. It's a Christopher Dresser. He's up the top there. It's his Egyptian pattern bowl.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Dresser's one of the giants for me, in my head.
Really?
Yeah.
This is probably not him. They've put it on a classical base.
Yeah.
Right. But for Victorian hallways, you know?
Yeah, because I always steer clear of them. Because,
yeah, you know, they're not popular now, I don't think. But the urn, you can see, has got the reeds. I've just done a little repair on it.
So we're wandering around and I see this very garish pedestal. Really not my sort of thing. This is horrible. And then Alan goes, oh, that's Christopher Dresser. And I'm looking at it going, it's not. And they said, no, there's a pot on top that's designed by Christopher Dresser. Immediately, my interest is piqued. One of my all-time favourite designers, right up there. Genius. That's that Dresser bowl.
That's right.
What, the two repairs? You've just done two. They're very small, aren't they?
I've just done it with a bit of enamel paint. That's all I've done.
Are they chips?
Yeah, just the surface glaze came off.
I think what's easier, by moving that, the other bit's lighter tea. Could you get
the pedestal
for me, please? It's beautiful.
Pretty, isn't it? Yeah. Do you like the glaze?
Love it.
British Racing Green with a bit of yellow, hey?
Love it. Beautiful. Gorgeous thing. What a lovely thing. What Dresser did was come up with something totally new. It's never been done since. Nobody's ever got it that right. No, I'm all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sort of works.
Strange, isn't it? Yeah.